Hi there. My name is Philoctetes, but you can call me Phil. I used to train heroes, but all those hotshots, Jason, Odysseus, Achilles, every one of those guys let me down. But then I met a gangly kid named Hercules. I asked myself, could he be a hero? Could he go the distance? Find out what happened to Hercules. Let's begin. At first, I didn't believe Hercules when he said that Zeus was his daddy. But sure enough, Herc was born on Mount Olympus to Zeus, ruler of the gods, and his wife, Hera. But Zeus hadn't always been head honcho. First, he had to conquer some brutes called Titans, oversized guys who caused earthquakes and volcanoes on Earth. Using his mighty thunderbolts, Zeus locked the Titans in a vault. Sometime later, the baby came along.
Oh, he's strong, like his dad. Mm.
Zeus threw a big bash for Herc and gave him Pegasus, a winged pony. One god left the party early. Hades, lord of the underworld, went below, plotting to get rid of Zeus so he could take over the universe. Hades called on the three fates, who knew everything about the past, present, and future.
Is this kid gonna mess up my hostile takeover bid or what? What do you think?
The fates looked into their all-seeing eye and told Hades that in 18 years, when the planets were perfectly aligned, he'd be successful. That is, unless Hercules fought on the side of the gods. Then Hades would fail. Right away, Hades sent his helpers Pain and Panic to kidnap Hercules. They took him to Earth and gave him a special potion to make him mortal. But as Hercules was gulping the potion, a man and woman walked up. The imps dropped the bottle. Which shattered before Hercules could finish the last drop. The kidnappers fled, leaving the baby with Amphitryon and his wife, Alcmene. Amphitryon read the boy's gold medallion.
Hercules?
Baby Hercules was human now, but since he hadn't finished the potion, he kept his amazing godlike strength. Sadly, Zeus and Hera knew their son could not return to Mount Olympus. Only the gods can live there. So Hercules grew up with Amphitryon and Alcmene, thinking they were his parents. Every year the boy grew stronger and clumsier. Every time Herc went to the marketplace with his dad, the big klutz caused some disaster.
Whoop!
Of course, his pop defended him.
He didn't mean any harm. He's just a kid. He just can't control his strength.
In private, Hercules talked to his dad.
I try to fit in. I really do. I just can't. Sometimes I feel like I'm supposed to be someplace else.
That evening, Amphitryon and Alcmene told Hercules that they were not his real parents. Alcmene gave him the gold medallion.
This was around your neck when we found you. It's the symbol of the gods.
Hercules set out for the Temple of Zeus. Once there, he asked his questions, and the huge statue came alive.
Hercules, if you can prove yourself a true hero on Earth, your godhood will be restored.
Zeus gave Hercules his old pal, Pegasus. That's where I came in. I was minding my own business when Hercules and Pegasus showed up. Zeus had told him where to find me. Philoctetes, trainer of heroes. Boy, was that kid determined.
Haven't you ever had a dream? Something you wanted so bad you'd do anything?
Once I found out his father was Zeus, I said, okay. I taught Hercules everything I knew. The kid was a total loser at first, and then he got it. But training's one thing. Becoming a true hero is another. To test Hercules, I decided to take him to Thebes, the toughest town in Greece. On the way, Herc tried to rescue a maiden from a burly centaur named Nessus. The lady objected.
Back off, Atlas. I can handle this.
But Herc was raring to prove himself. Before I knew it, Hercules and Nessus were fighting. Hercules won, but I had to tell him straight. Next time, don't let your guard down because of a pair of big goo-goo eyes! It was obvious that Hercules had a crush on the dame Megara. I didn't know then that Meg was in cahoots with Hades, and that Hades had done a quick burn when he learned that Hercules was still alive.
I'm about to rearrange the cosmos, and the one schlemiel who can louse it up is waltzing around in the woods! Fortunately for the three of you, we still have time to correct this oversight. And this time, no foul-ups.
While Hades plotted, Hercules and I headed into Big Bad Thebes. Surprise, surprise! Who should show up but Meg?
Please, help! Please! There's been a terrible accident!
Meg led Hercules to a gorge, where two little boys were trapped by a rock slide. Herc lifted an enormous boulder and freed the boys. The audience of Thebans barely clapped. At least the boys were impressed.
Jeepers, mister, you're really strong.
But Hades had a trick up his sleeve. The boys were really pain and panic. When Hercules lifted the boulder, he opened the entrance to a cave. In the cave lived a huge monster called the Hydra. As Herc fought the Hydra, I tried to coach. That's it, dance around, dance around. Watch the teeth, watch the teeth. Suddenly, the monster lashed out its tongue and swallowed the poor kid. Herc slashed his way out, chopping off the Hydra's head. The Hydra sprouted three more heads. Herc chopped them off. More grew in their place. Finally, when the monster had 30 heads, Hercules buried the beast by pounding his fists into the mountainside and causing an avalanche. Well, that did it. The people of Thebes went wild. Hercules became a mega superstar. His name and face were everywhere. It also didn't hurt that Hercules zapped every creature that Hades threw his way. A giant boar, a lion, a sea monster, the Minotaur. Finally, Hercules went to Zeus, convinced that he had become a hero. But Zeus gave him some bad news.
I'm afraid being famous isn't the same as being a true hero. It's something you have to discover for yourself. Look inside your heart.
Hercules wanted to quit, but I told him to hang in there. I seen them all, and I am telling you, and this is the honest to Zeus truth, you got something I never seen before. I can feel it right down to these stubby bow legs of mine. There is nothing you can't do. Except stay away from that blasted Meg. I couldn't believe it when Hercules sneaked out on a date with the gal, who, it turns out, was trying to buy her freedom from Hades. Seems Meg had sold her soul to save some old boyfriend. I searched all over for the two lovebirds. And when I finally caught up with him, I chewed out Hercules for being late to his workout. As I hurried him away, he still took time to give Meg a peck on the cheek. On the way to the stadium, I fell off Pegasus. Whoa. And landed where I overheard Hades talking to Meg.
You work for me. If I say sing, you say, hey, name that tune.
Meg was in cahoots with Hades. I knew this would break the kid's heart, but I had to warn him, and fast. I raced to the stadium. Hercules wouldn't listen.
I can't stop thinking about Meg. She's something else.
She's a fraud! She's been playing you for a sap!
Look, I know you're upset about today, but that's no reason to...
Kid, you're missing the point!
The point is, I love her.
She don't love you?
Stop it!
After that, I stormed out. And Hades made his move. He got Herc's attention by showing him Meg in chains. Hades was having a grand old time.
Okay, so here's the trade-off. You give up your strength for about 24 hours. Okay, say the next 24 hours. And Meg here is free as a bird and safe from harm. What do you say? Come on.
That crazy kid. He made the trade. But not before he made Hades promise that Meg would be safe from harm.
Fine, okay. I'll give you that one. Meg is safe. Otherwise, you get your strength right back, okay?
As soon as Hercules made the deal, all the strength drained out of him. Meg's chains disappeared. Then came the zinger. Hades told Herc that Meg had been working for him all the time.
It's not like that. I didn't mean to. I couldn't. I'm so sorry.
Hercules just stood there, heartbroken, while Hades hopped in his chariot and sped off into the dawn. Just like the fates had said, the planets were perfectly aligned. In no time, Hades freed the Titans. As they stormed Mount Olympus, Hades stopped the one-eyed Cyclops.
Hold it, Bright-Eye. I have a special job for you, my optic friend.
He sent the Cyclops to destroy Thebes and battle Hercules. Without his strength, Hercules was no match for the monster. After I left Hercules the stadium, I promised myself to forget about the kid. I was only interested in getting out of town. Then Meg flew up on Pegasus.
Phil, Hercules needs your help.
What does he need me for when he's got friends like you?
Look, I know what I did was wrong, but this isn't about me, it's about him. If you don't help him now, Phil, he'll die.
I hopped up beside Meg, and Pegasus zoomed us back to Hercules. Lightning flashed all around us, proof of the battle up on Mount Olympus. As soon as I saw Hercules, I tried to get him to fight.
You were right all along, Phil. Dreams are for rookies.
No, kid. Giving up is for rookies. I came back because I'm not quitting on you. I'm willing to go the distance. How about you? I must have gotten to the kid because he grabbed a burning piece of wood and blinded the Cyclops.
Whoa!
Then he wrapped a rope around the giant's ankles, and the Cyclops toppled over the cliff. As the Cyclops plunged toward the sea, it knocked over two large columns. One of the broken columns fell toward Herc.
Hercules, look out!
Meg pushed Hercules out of harm's way, only to have the column crash on top of her.
Meg! No!
Hercules tried to lift the heavy pillar. All of a sudden, the column gave way.
What's happening?
Meg smiled weakly as Hercules cradled her in his arms.
Hades' deal is broken. He promised I wouldn't get hurt.
Meg, why did you... You didn't have to...
People always do crazy things when they're in love.
Meg reached out to Hercules.
You can still stop Hades.
Slowly, Herc laid Meg in my arms. Then he leapt on Pegasus and they sped toward Mount Olympus. There, Herc discovered that Hades and the Titans had locked up the gods, including Zeus. Hercules freed the gods and fought the Titans with their help. Along with Zeus, Herc and the gods defeated Hades, who got in one parting shot.
Thanks a ton, Wonder Boy. But at least I've got one swell consolation prize. A friend of yours,
who's dying to see me.
Back on Earth, I did all I could to save Meg. But Hades and the Fates were determined to take her to the underworld. Once Hercules saw that Meg's spirit was gone, he dashed off to talk to Hades.
You like making deals. Take me in Meg's place.
Hades paused for a moment, then agreed. As Hercules dove into the pit of death, Hades cackled behind him.
You know what slipped my mind? You'll be dead before you can get to her. Is that a problem?
Hades happily watched as Hercules began to age. Then his joy turned to fury as Herc's body suddenly returned to normal.
This is impossible. You can't be alive. You'd have to be a
god?
Pain and panic watched as Hercules carried Meg's spirit past Hades. At first, Hades tried to stop Herc and smooth things over, but Hercules got so mad that he punched Hades, knocking him backward and trapping him in the pit of death.
No! Well, let me out! Let me out!
Hercules carried Meg's spirit back to her body, and Meg came back to life. When she smiled, I laughed and cried all at once. Later, on Mount Olympus, Zeus hailed his son.
For a true hero isn't measured by the size of his strength, but by the strength of his heart.
When Zeus and Hera welcomed Hercules home, Hercules grabbed Meg's hand.
Father, this is the moment I've always dreamed of. But a life without Meg, even an immortal life, would be empty. I wish to stay on Earth with her. I finally know where I belong.
Herc returned to Earth with Meg. And see that group of stars? Zeus put it there. That's Hercules. Yep, I finally trained a champ.